What's going on?
Wait, who's it? Who is this? Nick Bonino?
Yeah, this is him.
Oh, I thought I traded for somebody different.
I should say that phone call, the beginning of it was pretty funny. He called me the wrong name, asked me, oh, we traded for this guy. So I was, you know, a minute out of being traded. I was shocked. I was like, Billy, give me a second to compose myself here.
What's going on?
Not too much. You all right?
I'm always ready, Billy. So.
I know you are.
It's nice talking with Billy when he's in a jokey mood, but, you know, when he does get serious with you, it makes it that much more important.
We want to win, and you're a culture guy, and you're a good player, and you're what we need here.
Good. I'm excited. I'm obviously very excited.
All the way down, all the way up. Pull that shoulder blade back.
It's definitely a nice feeling. It's humbling to think I'm held in that esteem with a GM. Trades are weird, you know. I feel like every trade I've been in, there's nothing bad about me. You know, I'm not hearing anything bad. It's more that, you know, you have value when you're traded.
And the Pittsburgh Penguins have won the Stanley Cup!
Good to finally be in the rink here. It's good to be in a gym. I've kind of been working out either in a hotel gym at 5:30 in the morning on our road trip or in my basement. So to get into a gym and do some workouts here has been really good. Nothing's normal. So, you know, might as well add a trade in there with the way the world is right now and see how it goes. I told Suits like Sunday night, I was all giddy. It was like the first day of school, going to meet all my new classmates, all my new friends. Hey, let's have a good skate, boys.
Yeah,
here we go, short and hard. Came in, it was just those two guys, and it's been fun skating with them, with Bugie and Suits. So I'll bump from Suits and then get one from you. You're used to being able to, you know, go to a guy's house and meet the family, and I know guys on the team have reached out and been super welcoming, but, you know, in times like these, it's, you're not going in other people's houses too much. You're being pretty cautious, so it's definitely been a different transition than I'm used to.
We might need a new drill. This drill's too tough. I'll flip one hard to him. He's got to hold it, bring it down the wall. We kind of skate into it, do like a, and then I'll pop hard to the middle for a shot from you. Oh yeah, forget my own drill.
All right, let's do point shots.
Yeah.
Should we add some cutbacks into it?
Yeah, we're on camera, so. Oh, 0-6. We gotta be better. Great save. Nice. Oh. 45 minutes, pretty good. Let me get one goal here. That's for the camera.
Excited? I'll help you. Don't be scared.
But I want Daddy.
You want Daddy. I know. We're going to get Daddy right now. This is Daddy's new hockey rink, Minnesota
Wild.
Yes.
Okay.
Come on.
We're at Tria Rink here in St. Paul with the family. The best Bonino hockey player, my wife Lauren there, who I met at Boston University. We both played hockey there. This is Isabel, who wants me to skate fast, like every coach I've ever had. And that's my oldest there, Maisie. So this is her third time on the ice. We skated a little bit this off season with everything suspended here. The ice is open all the time. So lucky to have access to this beautiful facility and take these kids out, skate with them. So that's what we're doing here. You want to skate fast?
Yeah.
Okay. How fast?
This fast, like this.
Oh, that fast?
I need to do that, Daddy.
Good job. You're going so fast.
My daughter, Maisie, is almost 5, and my younger daughter, Isabel, is about 2.5.
Use those feet. Skate.
It's been a blessing in disguise having this time together as a family. You know, a lot of families don't get this. Even in retirement, your kids are older, so this has been a total blessing in disguise to have them around.
Nice, Maisie.
I didn't have as much time with Maisie as I have with Isabel in these, you know, early, you know, when she's been 2. Being with her every day from March all the way to July was pretty amazing.
Mommy's giving Maisie some private lessons.
Let's go, let's go. Go, go, go.
My wife, Lauren, and we've been married a while now. Got married in 2014.
Ready?
I walked her to class our first day of school freshman year. She played hockey at Boston University, same as me.
I thought he was so funny. I remember he was making me laugh the whole time. And then after that, we just hung out and we've been together.
I turned on the charm and and here we are now.
Go, Maisie, go. Ultimate dad. I know, he's just the fun one. He's always entertaining and thinking of fun things that they could do, and they love him.
Bonino has the puck over the blue line to the hash mark. She shot that score! Sky, yes, woo!
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 Woo! We'll work on it.
You grow up in New England, you know BU, BC, you're familiar with the Bean Pot. They just built such a brand new, amazing facility there at Aganis Arena. It was a really good setup, and yeah, I couldn't resist.
Bonino shoots and scores!
We were the number one seed all year. We had a crazy finals in Washington to beat Miami, Ohio, and that was kind of the cherry on top. Just winning in that fashion, I think, was really neat.
Never got it to the near side. Again, a centering pass, on goal, score!
We're the number one team in the nation. This was the 16th seed in the tournament who had just got in and had made a miracle run and was playing unbelievable hockey. You hear stories of them having the trophy in their hallway, you know, with 2 minutes left in the game, they're up 2 goals.
Backhander, save made, held the post, rebound in the middle, they score!
When they got a goal, I was obviously like, oh, this could still happen, you know? I never give up, no matter what the score is, I'll watch it till the end of the game. You just don't know what can happen in the last minute. I've always viewed him as a game changer. Personally, I know maybe I'm a little bit biased, but I always in college I'd be like, Nick just has to get out there. Like, I know he can change the game. I feel that way now too. I've always felt that way.
Rebound held on to. 20 seconds in the middle. Pass. Score! Unbelievable!
I love watching him score, obviously.
I think we knew, you know, after tying the game up in that fashion that we would win in overtime.
At the point, he'll go back and forth with it. Wind up shot, deflected, score! And Boston University is your Division I champion!
I think winning always gives you confidence. You know, I've been lucky to win at every level. I shouldn't say lucky, obviously I work hard at it, but you don't win on your own. You win with great teammates, you win with great coaches, you win with great staff. I think for me, college really helped me round out my game to become a 200-foot player. By the time I left BU, I was one of the better defensive forwards in the country, and I take a lot of pride in that. I take a lot of pride in my defensive game now, and it's something that I definitely, you know, honed at BU. Bike ride today, we have an off day, nothing at the rink, so come flush the legs, a little bit colder than I'm used to. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. Dedicated, probably do 5-6 hour ride today. I've never worn these booty things, I just got them. Struggling a bit getting them strapped on, but get my gloves and then I'm good to go. Everyone wants to be outside more. I think that was one of the biggest reasons I started cycling, because you could do it with buddies. You could stay distanced pretty easily. It's a great workout, obviously. You can kind of just forget about things. You just ride. You're not really thinking much. Obviously, you got to be a little bit aware for cars and stuff, but you're just outside, wind's blowing, climbing hills. A nice way to exercise.
People think I'm training for the Tour de France. Just an amateur. My fingers are frozen. These are not good. They said they were rated to down to 5 degrees Fahrenheit. The booties are good. They're fine. For 4 hours now, so we've gone far. It's probably what, 60, 70 miles. So I don't know how many loops, 40 loops of this thing, but ready for a coffee. Oh, that was smooth. Here at a local coffee shop, Isles Bun and Coffee. So leave the bike out here, go in, get some espresso, maybe a pastry, and call it a day. Can I get a double shot of espresso?
Yeah.
And then I'll do 4 cinnamon buns to go. Thank you. Great spot. I mean, these cinnamon buns, they're hot to the touch. Frosting, shouldn't it? I need to try just a... Yeah, pretty good. See if those make it home to my wife. It's tough to make a really solid shot of espresso. You can kind of taste it. One is too quick or too slow, so kind of nerdy, but it's become sort of a little hobby of my wife and I, so we dialed in the espresso back at home. We call it bone espresso. So I'm called Bones. We put espresso and bones together, and went on Etsy, had a nice little sign made for us. I went with the ECM Synchronica. It has flow control, so you can, with this lever here, control the amount of water coming in and out. Top baristas can use it to really change the flavor profiles. But for me, it's just set always here at 3 o'clock. This is the hot water, and this is the steam wand, and then this will be the temperature of the coffee water. Grinders are really important. They're probably more important than the machines, than the espresso machine, the coffee machine, the beans. Really are so important, first of all that they're fresh, and second of all that they're ground to the correct coarseness. I bet nobody expected this much goes into it, but I didn't either. Now I'm addicted, so hope you enjoy the process. Coffee will be on now. So we'll get it set to zero, so anything I add now will show up. Grinder here is a Chiato. It's really, really powerful. Shooting for around 18. That looks like it might need a little bit more. Yeah. This is a WDT. It's a distributor, so it kind of just breaks up clumps. If you're looking for like a pretty smooth stream, then this is our tamper here. So we'll just push it down. Then I'll polish it there, and now it's good. So. Doesn't seem that complicated, but I've been doing this a while. Keep your hand on this. When it starts to get like too hot to touch, that's when you know it's done. Both are done around the same time. All right, moment of truth. I don't know too much milk. There you go. Got a latte. Got a nice cup of coffee. Coffee's up. All the kids stop in front and do like the frosty arms. They're just pulling a sled. Hey, Maze! There we go. Now he's done.
right out of college. I got called up, I signed, they brought me in for 9 games. I was playing with Perry, with Solani, with Bobby Ryan.
When I walked into that locker room, it was Timu, Solani, Chris Pronger. I mean, you go down the line, there was name after name, Getzlaff, Perry. I was crapping my pants, like for real. I remember sitting on the bench my first game and my heart was beating out of my neck. It was like boom, 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 and they're like, chill, dude. When Nick came in, I wanted to just be like, hey, this is what you can expect. This is the way it's gonna be. These guys are great. Just sit back and watch.
We had some legends on that team. We had T, and I got to play with Timu for a lot. It was really fun. You know, he had an assist on my first goal.
Fires it across, looking for Solani, taps it into the middle, and Bonino gets his first NHL goal. And who picks it out of the net but the man who's got 600 of them?
That next year was a tough year. Randy was the coach, and I was only up for 26 games.
When you first get your chance in the NHL, it's kind of baptism by fire, and they do allow you to go out there and fail a little bit because they want to see how you're going to respond. It's not easy, but a credit to him, because it is easy to get discouraged when you go up there and you don't get the results you want. But to keep your head and to be able to go up and down, figure it out, and find ways to gain confidence even in tough times, I mean, I think that says a lot about him. And then obviously he's had a wonderful career since then.
Bonino straight up the middle. He's got the extra rhythm. He shoots, he scores.
It was new for me getting traded at that point, but you know, went into Vancouver and I thought we had a really, really great year. We had a pretty good team. That was a shock though from Vancouver, but ended up being, you know, the best thing that could have happened to me.
Paul looked to the right side, now comes to Bonino, he scores! Nick Bonino with another big goal in the month of March. Hornquist, his shot, stop, rebound, score! Nick Bonino!
I think I just embraced my role. It took a little while to get going, it was a slow start for me, but you play behind Sid and G, you know they're gonna play the majority of the line share, the power play, but you just have to show up and do your job. And my job, a lot of the time in Pittsburgh, was taking a lot of D-zone draws, D-zone starts, chipping in offensively when we could. I think when Gino went down and I was able to play with Phil and Haggy, and we started producing that first year I was there, that was some of the, you know, most fun hockey I've ever played. We scored every game, it seemed like. It didn't stop. It continued all the way through the playoffs.
Kessel up with it there. Ben went around in front. Haglund, he should have scored! Kessel near Ulta. Back to Milligan. Bonino, 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 Bonino. And the Pittsburgh Penguins have won the Stanley Cup.
To be able to see him on the ice afterward and to be able to give him a hug and Maisie to send the cup is just the most incredible feeling in the world.
And then coming back the next year, we had that swagger. We kind of knew we were the best team. It was more business. We knew how good we were, how good of a team we had, and we were going to repeat no matter what. And that ended up happening.
The Pittsburgh Penguins have done it again. Back-to-back Stanley Cup victories.
It was pretty amazing. It was a feeling that that you work for your whole life. And when it's done now, it's you know, it's a feeling you want back. It's, you know, you're kind of pissed off when you see someone else lifting it. You're like, you know, I had my day with that, with the cup. I had my time with it. I don't like seeing anyone else with it. We were talking with Pittsburgh, but I think for me, I wanted the term. I wanted 4 years, and Nashville right out of the gate was interested.
Here's Bonino, who scores!
We had an amazing time in Nashville. We won the President's Trophy that next year. We had a team to win the cup that year, and it's frustrating that we didn't get back there. So I think we were kind of, you know, after that, kind of searching for it a bit. And we had good players in Nashville, and we just couldn't put together at the right time. So I love my time there, though, for sure.
Aside from, I think, your rookie year, there was one season where the team you were on didn't make the playoffs. And that might go all the way back to high school, for all I know. How much of that is luck? And how much of that is there's something to be said there?
It must be all me, right? It's a little bit of luck. I like to think I have a hand in it. I like to think I'm contributing to playoff teams, offensively and defensively, and in the locker room. But hopefully that continues here.
And right off the draw, Nick Bonino scored.
I think one of my strengths is my ability to play up and down the lineup. Nowadays, the guys who are getting a ton of points, a lot of it's on the power play. I think even strength, you know, I've had 35 points even strength. I'd like to continue production at that pace. My ability to play with any player, I think, has always been a strength of mine. Just try to distribute the puck, make smart plays, win face-offs, whether we're O-zone or D-zone, and try to chip in offensively. That's always been my game, so I'm definitely excited for the opportunity.
I think if anything, you want to win more, having won. And when you're with teammates that you care about, maybe teammates that haven't won, you want that feeling for them. So I think Nick, when we got traded here, he ultimately I want to win.
Winning experience in the playoffs matters. The Wild are starting to get younger, and there's some of these core pieces that are developing. To have a veteran player like that, that's really for me what it's about, is he's been there before, he's won before, and that experience is priceless.
My intention here is not to come in and give rousing speeches and tell guys how to win. You know, guys in the NHL have won at all levels, they know what it takes, and for me it's just gonna be, you know, leading, maybe vocally, but a lot of the time leading by example. I find that when I'm not scoring or when I'm not producing, I'm usually still doing, you know, good things on the ice. I'm still positive. I think that's the most important thing I can try to impart is to be positive, regardless of how things are going. So that'll be kind of how I approach this season. So we're writing everything down, 18 grams in, we got 39 out, but it took 26 seconds, which is actually really good. The grind was at a 2. I'm not sure what all this even means right now. The drip usually starts a lot sooner than that. I feel like I could talk coffee to you guys all day. But yeah, I'm just rambling on. This will be in the outtakes.